Good morning and welcome back to the Survival Series with Doc Stout. I am Doc Stout, and today we're playing Don't Starve. For the Survival Series, I will probably be playing different survival games until I either die or looks like it's no longer has the possibility to be entertaining. And I've played Don't Starve long enough that I think that probably going to get to the point where I die preparing for winter. We are on day three in episode two here with the strong man, the art of manliness. Let's continue. Let's see where we're at. We still don't have a camp. We just woke up at a second temporary campsite. We haven't found any beefalo. We haven't found any gold. And we barely got any food. Our stomach is not doing so hot, but I do have a little bit of food on me. Replenish some of those logs. I cannot spend my entire day gathering logs and grass like I have been, though. I need to actually find something relevant. Let's eat some carrot. Eat some berry. I do still have a trap that I found that was at 38%. Are we going in the direction of new? Okay, we're gonna have to... Let's hit the road. Flee before me, little bunny. I guess we'll eat the seed, too. Alright, now we're getting into uncharted territory. I have to decide whether I want to cook that berry and eat it or use it as bait. So got carrots. Oh, now we're cooking. Let's accidentally leave a berry bush to grab a second berry bush. Almost got enough to get strong. I wonder if I could... Yeah, let's... Don't you wander towards me. I want to eat you. Damn it. Ugh. Alright. Fine. Okay, that's some bees. We will not be going there. Wow, lots of bees. Yeah, that's a nightmare. We got a brick road down there. Let's follow the brick road. Okay, now we've got plenty of bunnies again. Let's try the trap trick. Gosh darn it. Gonna try and get a morsel. I think I've only killed one. I don't want to eat those raw. So slow. Should be doing something useful with my time. Like preparing to mine that rock. There we go. Murder. A quick bit of murder for tonight's supper. Come on, gold. Nitra. I'm getting a lot of rocks and flint. Let me just make sure. Yeah. I need one chunk of gold. Flee before me. I almost wonder if I have to find a rock that has gold chunks in it, or if it's just an extremely low drop rate. So I would like to start doing some science. Of course, I still have to find a beefalo herd in order to find a permanent campsite, I think. He's hard, like me. Probably if I wanted to go for maximum efficiency, I'd be making a torch and running around at night. But I know that one of the new downsides to this character is that he's afraid of the dark. So I don't know if that's a good thing or not. Plus, I've never liked running around at night in this game. Just feels like it's against the point of it. Scary time is coming soon. Alright, let's get a little bit more exploration in before we camp for the night. Although I'm wandering into uncharted territory at night. I suppose I'll hear the spiders if I wander too close to a spider lair. And I suppose I can chop these trees. We'll have to establish a camp here for the night. I got a little bit of time. Not much. We found the other end of that wormhole. Hoping to find some beefalo. Oh, what's this? Okay. So, we found a part of the strange device, which I think takes us into survival mode. It used to do many, many different things. No, we're not going to make a permanent campsite yet. Let's switch to the axe. Cut some firewood for the night, and then I can start cooking dinner, because I am nuts. Particularly good on hunger right now. I may want to pick some flowers in the morning too. Cook up some carrots, some berries, and I will cook the murdered rabbit. Delicious, delicious murder. Alright, berry, morsel. Carrots, I'm not actually sure if food variety matters that much, but fire is not hot enough. Alright, we'll throw a log on there. And another one. That should be fine for the night. I might have to restock it once. But on day 3, we have uncovered a bit more of the map. We can walk back to the west a little bit. We still found 0 beefalo. We found part of the strange thing. Let's see, what can I make right now? I can make a grass suit, which I may end up doing. Without a science machine, I can make traps. I'm actually going to have to start picking twigs and grass soon again. I can make all forms of fire, and I can make basic tools. The only hat I can make is a flower hat. My pretty flower bonnets, I will end them. Well, let's not plunge. Okay, my sanity's okay. My stomach is back to not great, but we have a deep pit of a stomach. My apologies if you're watching on Twitch today. I got a late start, so I did not set up the laptop so I can watch chat. Alright, let's grab some grass and get a little bit more exploration away from the spiders. So we slow down to save. I mean, there's got to be beefalo around here somewhere, you'd think. Just got to look for telltale signs of poop. How many sticks do I have? Plenty. We're at day 4. We've got some time before winter, but it becomes very difficult come winter to survive. I've made it through a few winters, but that was before patches. Like, I haven't played since they came out with Reign of Giants. And I've heard that you kind of want to master all the new systems that they put in place before going to Reign of Giants, because they add summer and spring, which I guess present some new challenges. We're not going to stomp on the spider webs and wake those guys up. I don't see any point to doing that. Okay, we got more spiders over here. Oh, these were the spiders I found earlier. Okay, we got some free stuff here. Got some rope. Some free rot. I don't think I want that. And a feather hat. What does that do? I don't know. Looks cool. Oh, it's a fishing rod. Maybe I can get some fish. Alright, well, that bit of exploration seems to have paid off. Oh, I want to get over there. It looks like there's some unpicked berry bushes. We're also getting to the point where I'm going to have to start planting trees. Because I don't know if actually planting trees when you're not near a... I forget the name of the big monster that trees turn into, but I'm not sure if planting them randomly keeps his spawn rate down, or if you just gotta plant him to put him back to sleep. So many things that I've forgotten, and so many things that I never knew in all my hours playing this game. Alright. We've got a little bit of food. Maybe not enough to get us back to exactly where we were tonight, but enough that I am confident in continuing to explore. I will grab berries as I see them, though. There's another carrot. Oh, I do not have a weapon suitable for getting that turkey. It's a shame, because that's some easy meat. If I'm going to spawn turkeys, I definitely want to hit all the berry bushes. No sense in letting other creatures eat. Alright, we have a very large vegetarian diet at the moment. And we still don't have a site for camp. Which makes me a little nervous. I'm going to actually leave those berries and carrots for later. Got 9 and 5. I think I'm actually going to want to wander over here so I don't scare the bunny back into his hole. And let's use the trap again. He is bound and determined to be scared off by me today. No, don't eat it. Bait the trap. Oh, wow, we got a lot of food for the moment. Enough that I'm actually going to eat some raw. Man, no. Actually, spawning that thing doesn't seem to have done anything. Wow, okay, yeah, it just bum-rushed me. I am totally fine with that. Let's drop the petals for now, because tonight we dine on drumsticks. I'd love to be able to honey glaze them, but we are ages away from being able to do anything that cool. I actually don't remember if the last time I played, if they actually dropped drumsticks or if they just dropped morsels. Oh, we've got so many berry bushes. I'm almost tempted to camp here, but we need to discover some beefalo. Yeah, well, at least try to box this area out a little bit. See if there are any threats down here. I mean, it may well be that I will make a temporary camp, but I don't like making a camp without a science machine either, and we have not found any gold up to this point. Which is annoying. We got a breezy vest there. Well, we'll just take that. I'm finding all sorts of cool clothes and accessories. Alright, let's make a fire before I just die due to, what? Why am I not feeling so good? This may be something new for him, where if he gets a certain amount of... Okay, yeah. Wolfgang just needs to eat. Warrior needs food badly. We have plenty of logs for the fire. Do a quick bit of murder. For a moment, I thought it was one of the vests or something. Wow. Okay, let's cook that last. Okay, fine. Alright, let's eat a bit, because he is not happy with the amount of food he's got in his belly. Oh, wow. That's just about filled me up. Do I want to go all the way to Mighty? Alright, we're Mighty. Fire is not hot enough. Okay, we have a stylish hat, a breezy vest, and we still don't have a campsite, but we've got a bit of food, and we're Mighty walking our way into day 5. I think I'm going to call it here. 2 days seems to be a good length for an episode. I would like to thank you for watching. I will be back tomorrow with more Don't Starve, where we will continue our quest to find a bit of gold and a spot where we can actually establish a more permanent camp and then start preparing for winter. We've already got a breezy vest, but I don't know that it's going to last through a winter. So I definitely need to get a science machine rolling so I can research various things to, like, prepare food, stockpile clothing, maybe make a heat rock. But until next time, this has been Doc Stout with the Survivor Series, Don't Starve, and I am signing out.